Good evening to all of you and welcome you all, my dear press friends. Dr. Vetri Kumar, Mr. Neela Shankar. Parvati Hospital has been innovating a lot of technologies. புதுமை செய்ய வேண்டும் என்று பல முயற்சிகள் நாங்கள் எடுத்துக்கொண்டிருக்கிறோம். ஒவ்வொரு தடவை புதுமை செய்யணுங்கிறது வந்து எதுக்காகன்னா, புதுமை செய்யறதுக்காக இல்லை, ஸோ அந்த புதுமையினால் ஏதாவது பேஷண்ட்ஸ்க்கு பெனிஃபிட் கிடைக்குமா, டு ஹெல்ப் த பேஷண்ட் அண்ட் டு மேக் தம் ஃபீல் பெட்டர், ஹவு டு மேக் லைஃப் பெட்டர் ஃபார் பேஷண்ட்ஸ், தட்ஸ் வாட் வி ஆர் ஸ்ட்ரைவிங் ஹார்ட் டு டூ. அண்ட் எவ்ரி டைம் வி டூ, வி ஷுட் தேங்க் த ப்ரெஸ் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹூ ஹேட் ஆல்வேஸ் பீன் ப்ரொஜெக்டிங் இட் அண்ட் டேக்கிங் இட் டு த பப்ளிக். தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபார் தட். திஸ் டைம் வி ஹவ் கம் அவுட் வித் அ நியூ வே ஆஃப் லுக்கிங் அட் the entire way we look at the knee replacement surgeries. So far I would have done around 2000 surgeries, but now I came to a stage that I thought the knee replacement is a routine, ella nalla pannit irukom adina nanichirukkum bodhu there was a scope for improvement. Then Dr. Vetri Kumar, I welcome him. Dr. Vetri Kumar, a young surgeon who is focused knee surgeon. He just does only knee replacement surgeries. And he came and he has innovated, he has brought in new technologies, of which one of this new way of looking at the knee is being projected. And I pass over the mic to Dr. Vetri Kumar to take over and take this session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for the introduction.
So whenever I was there, I always felt that India was always lacking, especially not about the surgery, how we approach the procedure, how we approach the surgery. So that's where the entire change was happening. And I always felt that there's a big gap between India and US and the way they perform procedures and all that. So I thought I have to bring the same kind of protocols and everything over to India. So I truly and strongly believe that. So what we have achieved right now, we have gone a step ahead and we have gone much closer towards US, the care which is getting, which they give to US patients. So we are also trying towards, we are trying to catch it up. And so this one thing which we have done today, so I'm presenting you, Mrs. Neela Shankar. So India's first outpatient joint replacement surgery patient on whom we have performed. And thank you, Mrs. Neela Shankar. She has been with us. She's very kind enough. She's just post-operative day 8 and we have not even removed those sutures. So now she's walking around and she's with us. So thanks a lot for coming and joining us. So I think this is the first transformation which happened for us this year. So this when everywhere they were doing total knee replacements and in and out. So I always felt that total knee replacement is no doubt, it's a definitely a very good procedure, but when it's done for a very badly done, damaged one, when patient just has pain and still they, otherwise there it's a normally functioning knee joint, so the patient doesn't get good satisfaction out of total knee replacement. So always, it's the worldwide statistics that, you know, total knee replacements gives around 85 to 88% satisfaction rate. So when all through the US, they have just, I mean all through in India, they just performed total knee replacement as their only solution for any knee arthritic problem. I felt that there is much more scope where you can give, you know, more, better quality care in regards to surgical treatment. So then I came up with partial knee replacement surgeries. So here it's definitely a less small, minimal invasive procedure, lesser bone loss, less blood loss, since the injury is far less and we just resurface the procedure. It's more of a resurfacing procedure. We just address the issue. So more 80% of the natural knee joint is retained, so the patient can feel the natural knee joint again. So all the ligaments, everything is still preserved. It's more joint preserving surgery. So the feel of the knee joint is still intact. So patient satisfaction rate keeps increasing because of that. And it doesn't stop there. So the next transformation, the second transformation, and this is the gateway for that. So this partial knee replacement helped us to open up the is outpatient daycare, outpatient or daycare joint replacement surgeries. So what I truly mean by outpatient joint replacement surgery is the patient walks in by the morning and gets their procedure done, and she walks back to her home the same day, evening, without any IV lines, no catheters, no urinary catheters. She walks back just like that with the walker support, and the recovery and rehab, everything happens at home. So isn't it something amazing? So total knee replacement, previously how it was giving them medicines and then walk, next day morning they'll walk with urinary catheters, with so many drains and with so many, you know, so many attachments and connection with them. So, but just imagine a situation where, you know, in the morning you have a surgery, the next day you're walking without anything at the comfort of your home, looking at the face of your family members, you know, being in the couch and sipping a coffee inside the home, and you walk alone without anyone's support, going to the restroom without any catheter. So that's exactly what she was experiencing on the day one of her procedure. So how we achieve, this is a definitely a big game changer. It is just not about how we did the procedure. This is a team approach. It's not just about the surgeon. So it's a team approach. The entire team, right from the top, staff, nurses, everyone should be on the same page. So this starts right from the patient selection. So that itself is a very critical thing. So how to do this in a very safe way? So me and my anesthetist, and we had some references from the US as well. So we came up with a tool of how to analyze the risk and do it in a much safer way. So patient selection plays a very important role. And as I previously told, pre-op education and training, most of the work happens pre-operatively rather than happening in the post-operatively. Nothing, no surprises after the procedure. So in fact, our therapists, they go to the patient's house pre-operatively itself, see if there are any barriers inside the house, and also train them with a walker. So patient doesn't suddenly come up with seeing a walker after the surgery, doesn't know how to walk. So they'll be trained before the procedure itself how to walk. So it goes inside her memory, and right after the procedure, everything is all familiar to her. So all these things makes a big difference. And we spend one whole day educating the patient as well as the caregiver on how to do, how will be the procedure day, what exactly happens inside the procedure and everything. So everything is well discussed, and the patient and the entire surgical team are in one single page. And of course, for this, it's just not about the verbal communication, okay, anesthetist, you give the anesthesia this time. It doesn't happen like that. So we have very strict standard protocols. We charted out each and every detail to the minuscule, we have charted out, and we work accordingly. So only then we can achieve. Here, it's all about precision and timing. So every single minute matters a lot. For example, when the patient comes in the morning by 5:30, the procedure will start exactly by 6:30, and then by 1 p.m. she'll be having her lunch, and by 2 o'clock, the therapist will come and like make her walk with some few baby steps, and then by 4 to 6 p.m., she will be walking around the ward, train her for the toilets, and then by 6:30, she will be planning for discharge. So everything, for all this to happen, everything goes by exact timing. Every medicines given by the staff nurse, we act very proactively. We don't ask for the patient, okay, do you have pain and like that. So even before anything comes, we act. So pain is well taken care of even before they complain of that. So, and this definitely cannot happen just overnight. Overnight, we cannot come up with a daycare procedure. So our previous clinical results have constantly proved that. So when we started initially, it was all 3 days after we sent the patient home, 3 days, 5 days. Now we have gradually reduced it to 1 day, and then we can achieve this daycare procedure. And we learn a lot from our own patients. Our patients are the biggest resources. So we try to learn so much from the patients and get every information from them, and how to make it more simpler. The procedure, making it more simpler, so that's how we learn. So here is a graph, which you can see, from 1987 to 97, those days, single site replacement surgery will almost take a patient to stay in the hospital for almost 7 days. Then gradually by 97 and 2000, it will reduce to 5 days. And then after that, around 4 days and 3 days, and 2 days, and like 2017 onwards, it became around like 1.5 days to 2 days. And right now, 2018, it's 14 hours. So this year, we've started, it's gone to 14 hours. And this is how I look at the future. of the length of stay. For example, a unicondylar knee surgery, the partial knee replacement, will take around 2.2, and total knee replacement takes around 3.3, and total shoulder replacement will take around 4.4 hours, and hip around 4.6. So previously we used to discuss about all these 3.1, 2.1, 4.4, everything was in days, but now it's going to change to hours. All right, so this is our patient satisfaction survey rate. So this clearly indicates that once the length of stay goes down, the patient satisfaction goes more higher and higher. So that's mainly because one of the biggest factors that influence a patient satisfaction is their anxiousness towards the surgery and the fear of surgery and anxiousness towards the hospital admission. So 2015, when our length of stay was pretty high, so 2000, it was around 87% where patients said it was great to undergo a total knee replacement surgery. Whereas when it comes to 2008, as our length of stay goes down, so it starts to increase around 90% and 91.8%. So at around 98% of the patients feel that the surgery is around great to good. So probably we are achieving more, we'll keep achieving more as the length of stay goes down. So more great results is what we are expecting. So me and my anesthetist, enough studies which have already come up. So US are the pioneers in this. They have come up with so many studies, and almost every month they keep coming up plenty of studies. Around last 2 years study, it shows around 1,230 joint replacements are done. And there are like plenty of other studies which keeps saying that it's a safe, very safe procedure, and it can be done very effectively. So around 2050, they expect around 1.4 million to 4 million outpatient joint replacement surgeries in US. So here I've pulled up the data from the United States. So from 2011 to 17, they 76 centers in 19 states of United States performed around 19,415 total joint replacement surgeries. So this is why I was saying we were lacking a lot, and now we are a step closer. So 7,227 unis have been performed, and 6,146 total knees, and 5,000 total hips, and 940 revisions of total shoulder arthroplasty has been done already in the United States as a daycare procedure. So we are just starting now. I've discussed this with my colleagues in other departments as well. So we are soon going to come up with total knee replacement as a daycare procedure, and ACL reconstruction also as a daycare procedure, and also the discectomies from the spine will also come soon as a daycare procedure. So, ladies and gentlemen, so you might have seen two to three decades back, you know, patients wearing big bandages, big plasters and spikers, like cast and all that. When someone gets a fracture, lying in the bed for such a long time, and they start walking after 1 hour, 1.5 months, 2 months, 3 months is what they can even start walking. See how it has transformed right now. You get injured, you get a fracture now, we fix it right away, and then you start walking in the same way. The same way, this is going to be a game changer here. A patient is going to come right in the morning and going to have the procedure done, and then walk back after a joint replacement surgery on the same day. Getting admitted inside a hospital for a joint replacement surgery is going to become an obsolete. Thank you. And I have Mrs. Leela Shankar. I request her to have a few minutes.
എനിക്ക് ഭയങ്കര പേടിയായിരുന്നു. അതായത് മുട്ടുമുള്ളിനെ മാറ്റിയ 3 മാസം 6 മാസം ആശുപത്രിയിൽ കിടക്കേണ്ടിവരുമെന്നാണ് പറഞ്ഞത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ പേടിച്ചിട്ട് പിന്നെ ഞാൻ ഒന്നും ചെയ്തില്ല. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷമാണ് ഞാൻ ഇവിടെ ഈ ആശുപത്രി പോയത്. അപ്പോഴാണ് മുട്ടുസാരം ഓപ്പറേഷൻ ചെയ്ത. പേടിക്കാനൊന്നുമില്ല, വേഗം നോക്കി നടക്കാൻ എല്ലാം ശരിയാവും എന്ന്. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് 9:00 ഉള്ളിലെ ദിവസം ഞാൻ തനിയെ കുറച്ച് മറക്കാനുള്ള ശ്രമം നടത്തി അങ്ങനെ നടന്നു. 4 ദിവസം മാത്രമേ ഞാൻ ബാക്കറി ഉപയോഗിക്കുള്ളൂ. ബാക്കി ഇപ്പൊന്നും ഞാൻ ബാക്കറി ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നില്ല. ഇപ്പൊ ഇങ്ങോട്ട് വന്നതും എല്ലാം വണ്ടി കയറിയതും അവിടുന്ന് ഞാൻ പോയതും എല്ലാം കാറിൽ ഇറങ്ങിയതും എല്ലാം നടന്നായിരുന്നു. ഇപ്പൊ ഇങ്ങോട്ട് വന്നതും ബാക്കറൊന്നും ഇല്ലാതെ നടന്നിട്ടാണ്. ഇവിടുന്നും എല്ലാം നടന്നു തന്നെയാണ്. നമുക്ക് ഭയങ്കര ഭയങ്കര എനിക്ക് സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. നന്നായി എല്ലാവരെയും എനിക്ക് ഭയങ്കര സന്തോഷമായി. നമ്മളൊരാളെ പോലെ നന്നായി എല്ലാം ചെയ്ത് ഇത്രയും വേഗം ഞാൻ നടക്കുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ സ്വപ്നത്തിൽ കൂടി വിചാരിക്കുന്നില്ല.
ബുധനാഴ്ചയാണ് ഞാൻ നടക്കാൻ തുടങ്ങി. ബോധം വന്നതിന് ശേഷം അതുകഴിഞ്ഞ് വൈകുന്നേരം ആശുപത്രി വെച്ചിരുന്ന 2 പ്രാവശ്യം നടക്കും. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് വൈകുന്നേരം ഡിസ്ചാർജ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും. വീടടുത്താവുമ്പോണ്ട് ആശുപത്രിയിൽ വേണ്ട. പിന്നെ ഒരു മോഡലേ ഉള്ളൂ. എനിക്ക് കഷ്ടമാവും.
ஆபரேஷன் பண்ண உடனே உங்களுக்கு வலி இருந்துச்சுதாமா? இப்பவும் வலி இருக்குதா? அந்த இடத்துல
வலி ஒட்டுமே இல்ல.
வலியே இல்லையா?
வலியே இல்ல. ஆபரேஷன் செய்தா அப்ப தொட்டே எனக்கு வலி இல்ல.
இல்ல வலி வராம இருக்கிறதுக்கு எதுவும் மெடிசின் கொடுத்திருந்தீங்களா சார்?
Yeah, of course, அதான் it's a biggest challenge. I mean, it's not an easy joke. orthopedic procedure, any bony procedure பண்ணிட்டு without pain free avachikadu, it's a very big challenge. So that's why I was telling, we always act very proactively. Our previous, you know, patients, everyone, like LRTM, medical data and everything has helped us. And how to manage pain is a big science. And me and our pain anesthetist, pain management team, we have worked on that. So
experience nala பேஷண்ட் அவர் சொன்ன மாதிரி முதல்ல 4 நாள் 3 நாள் இருந்து 2 நாள் போயிட்டு. பட் என்ன நாங்கள் கண்டுபிடிச்சோம்னா, அந்த அடுத்த நாள் சில பேர் டிஸ்சார்ஜ் பண்ண முடியும் ஈஸியாக. அடுத்த நாள் மத்தியானம் இல்லை சாயங்காலம் டிஸ்சார்ஜ் பண்ணால் காலையில் போக மாட்டோம். அதுக்கும் முந்தின நாள் டிஸ்சார்ஜ் பண்ணுறோம். பேஷண்ட்டுக்கு நிறைய டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் இருக்குது ஃபார் பேஷண்ட் பெனிஃபிட். அது பண்ணணும்னு நினச்சாவே இந்த சைடு மெடிக்கல் சைடில் நிறைய ஒர்க் இருக்குது. நிறைய ஆக்டிங் மெடிசன். அதுக்கப்புறம் வலி வராமல் இருக்கிறதுக்கு லாங் ஆக்டிங் மெடிசன். லாங் ஆக்டிங்னா ரொம்ப நேரம் அது வந்து பிளாக்னு சொல்லுவாங்க, அது மாதிரி கொடுத்து ரொம்ப நேரம் இருக்கிற மாதிரி. அதை தவிர சிஸ்டமிக் எஃபெக்ட்ஸ், அந்த சர்ஜரியோட எஃபெக்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ணுவோம் சில மாதிரி இருக்குது. இவ்வளோத்தையும் அதை வந்து அதுக்கெல்லாம் இம்பேக்ட் பண்ணி, அதை தவிர சில எக்யூப்மெண்ட்ஸும் அது யூஸ் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. பெயின் வரலாம்
சொல்லியிருக்கேன். அது வந்து சார், அது வந்து கீஹோல் சர்ஜரியா இது அல்லது ஓபன்?
மினி ஓபன். Keyhole joint replacement has never ever done anywhere. Mm-hmm. Keyhole joint replacement பண்ணவே முடியாது. So this is a mini open, like 3-finger breath, 4-finger breath maximum. So in the சின்ன mini open.
So what was the metal you used? Usually cobalt?
Yeah, this is cobalt chromium again.
Sir, observation. அதனால அவுட்பேஷண்டா போறதுனால ட்ரக்ஸ் எல்லாம் இருக்கிறதுலே லீஸ்ட் எல்லாமே சூஸ் பண்ணணும். லீஸ்ட் சைட் எஃபெக்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் பேஷன் அந்த மாதிரி. ஸோ இட்ஸ் அ டீம் எஃபெக்ட். முன்ன வந்து இன்பேஷன்னா ரொட்டீன் பே இன்பேஷன்ட் ஆகிடுவாங்க, எல்லாரும் சேர்ந்து பார்ப்பாங்க. பட் இதில் வந்து
கிட்ட கற்றுக்கி கிளம்பி போயிட்டாங்க. ஸோ அதுக்கப்புறமேட்டும் அதான் பெயினே இல்லை. ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் டேலேருந்து அவங்களே பாத்ரூம் டாய்லெட் போடுறது, ஸோ எல்லாமே அவங்களாலே பார்த்துக்க முடியுது வித்தவுட் எனி பெயின் ஃப்ரீ. ஸோ ஷி ஸ்டார்ட் டு வாக் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் த நெக்ஸ்ட் டே. ஸோ தட்ஸ் த பெஸ்ட் திங் விச் வி ஹவ் ட்ரைட் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் கம் வெரி சக்ஸஸ்ஃபுல். அண்ட் வி ஹோப் திஸ் ரிசர்ச்சிங் இந்த மாதிரி டே கேர் ப்ரொசீஜர்ஸ் ஆர் கோன் பி த ஃபியூச்சர் ஃபார் இன் இந்தியா. So most of the patients will actually get benefited out of this. For example, the cataract appear in which admit-aitive or not lirupanga and the mari yandhu. So if every kaalela on the cataract panning, the joint is going to be simplified. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.